Hello everyone, and welcome to this GeoGebra tutorial series for mathematics explorations. We have so far seen videos on labeling, formatting, display and movement of objects. We have seen how to enable the toolbar and the style bar, and also how to create text box and work with the input bar. In this video, we will be looking at the use of two features called the slider and the input box. One of the powerful features of GeoGebra is the ability to change the parameters of a construction that we can show to the students. And it's possible to change parameters either by defining a range of values that the parameters can take or by taking inputs from the students. Both allow for interactivity and the resource to be animated in a manner that the object properties can be explored and there can be a discussion on that in the classroom. Sliders and input boxes are two features that allow us to bring this kind of interactivity in. Sliders are when you define the parameters to vary within a given range. They can either be numeric values that can change for a parameter or values in degrees that can change for angle measures. Input boxes are yet another way of changing the parameters of a construction. This can be done by taking inputs from the students or from the users of the file. They can either be linked to the construction with the variables that we define in the input bar. We have already seen how to work with an input bar in one of the prior videos. Input boxes values can also be linked to the sliders. In other words, the input box can feed the value in the slider. Of course, what needs to be kept in mind is that the input box value that you input should be within the range that the slider has already been defined with. So with these two features, it is possible to bring in a lot of interactivity and make very powerful lessons. And we can also allow students to do self-exploration and learning with these kinds of files. Now I'm going to pause here for a minute while I bring up the GeoGebra window. So we will now be looking at the use of sliders and input boxes for a triangle construction with base and given two base angles, right? So now I will just plot a point A, which will be one of the vertices, and we want to define AB as the base, and we want to be taking two values for the angles, angle at A and angle at B. Now for this we will use a slider where we will change the values of the base and the base angles. So slider is this option that you see here next to the text box. When you click on the drop down, you select the first option here. Click anywhere on the graphics view. So we will define the value as, we'll define the name as base, I'm sorry. It's useful to give the name of the slider in such a manner that it denotes the parameter that you are seeking to vary. You can either have a number or you can have an integer, as the name suggests. So we'll take an integer where it can only take integer values and it will only take an increment of integers. So I will just define this as name of the integer slider, which is say base. And with the value from 1 to 30, 1 is too small, so maybe we'll define it at 5. Yep, so that is the first slider. Now, if I want to move the slider to position it to the left or the right, I need to right click it to make sure that this fix object box is not checked. If it is checked, uncheck it, use the move tool, and you can move the slider and position it wherever you wish on the graphics view. Then we will define two angle sliders as well. Go back to the slider, click again, define the angle. We will call it same logic of defining the name correctly, base angle 1. And we will define another slider called base angle 2. Yep, so base angle 2. Now again, I will move these sliders and position them. So now we have our point here, the base, sorry, the vertex. So we'll get this point here and then we will label it. And we will use the segment with a given length to use the slider in this construction to define the base of this triangle, right? So we'll choose this option, segment with given length, and we will take base, and you get your segment, the first side of the triangle. Label this vertex as well and position it so that it is displayed neatly. Now we will define the angles. So for that we use this option called the angle with a given size. You choose the leg point, the vertex, and then enter the size. Choose the leg point, the vertex, and the given size. And remember to choose the direction, anti-clockwise or clockwise. And I want to draw your attention to the fact that here there is a number that is coming here, and you need to not give a fixed number, but rather enter the name of the slider that you have defined. Otherwise, it's not a slider. It will only take one value. So now your one base angle has been constructed. We do the same thing with the second vertex as well. Now I will just draw these, extend this ray from A through B prime. And now we will come to constructing the angle at vertex B. Same tool option. Select the leg point is A and the vertex is B. Now we need to choose a clockwise rotation of the angle so that we get the interior angle within the triangle, base angle 2. You can increase the value of the slider so that the angle is visible. Now draw a ray from B to A prime and plot the intersection of these two rays, which will give you the desired triangle. Now to make this construction look neater, we can actually hide all these rays and all these rotated points, etc. So there is one of two ways of doing it. So I'll open the algebra view to demonstrate both the ways. You can either select the object on the graphics view, in this case this ray, and uncheck the show object box. Uncheck the show object box and it makes the rotated point as well as the ray be hidden. You can also do hiding the object from the algebra view, where you go and look at the ray B, which is still visible, indicated by a solid blue circle as against a white circle for the hidden ray. So now you right click it and uncheck the show object. Similarly, go to B prime and uncheck the show object. So that leaves you with only the intersected point. Join AC and BC and you get your triangle. You can also label the segment AB as ATE, and if you wish you can also show the values. So that is something that I'll select here and go name and value, object properties, name and value, and similarly name and value. For this lesson we don't really need to have one or two decimal places, so I'm going to go to an option here called rounding and round off my display to zero decimal places, right? And then we will move things around a little bit to make it look neater. So now you have our desired triangle. We will also label the angle at vertex C, right? So we have since we have defined the name and angle as a method of labeling, it's given you gamma equal to 81. So you may want to do the same thing for the other two angles as well for consistency. So I'll go here, object properties, basic, and I will choose the name and the value, right? So now you can keep changing the value of the sliders. So just move this around a little bit so that it's more neatly visible. Now we will see how to move the slider to change the parameter values. So you click on the arrow, move arrow here, and move the button on the slider by keeping your mouse on it. Or you can go and right click and set the slider on to an automatic movement. For that, you go and select animation on, and you notice that the slider is automatically moving. It's increasing in value and it is also decreasing in value. Now you can define the way the slider moves by selecting this option, either as oscillating or increasing or decreasing or increasing only once. In this case, we have set it to be oscillating, so it's increasing as well as decreasing. So I will stop the animation off now. I'll stop the animation. So by unchecking the animation on, now the animation is stopped and I can bring it back to a smaller triangle size. And there we have our triangle constructed with the slider for the base and the two base angles. So you can also demonstrate specific triangles here where the triangle disappears, right? So now there is no triangle. So these are some of the ways in which you can use a slider. Again, if the objects are sort of overlapping, just make sure you move them around for a good display. Now we have defined a slider with a certain range of values for the base as well as the base angles. Now I want to see if we can convert the same file by taking an input from the user. So for that, I will construct another triangle. We will plot another point here. We'll call this D. And I want to use the same method. I will use the same sliders for the angles, but I will demonstrate the input box use for the value of the base side. So now we want to go to algebra view first to see how the construction objects will get depicted on the algebra view. I will define a variable here called base length, right? And I will call it, say, 6. Yeah. So now the base length variable is defined here. So, and I can go here and then enter the segment with, use the segment with given length option to construct a triangle. So I will use the input bar, and we have to define the point D and the length. Here it is the base length. Yeah. So now I will use the same method to construct the two angles and actually plot the intersection points as well as hide the ray and the rotated point, etc. So you will see the completed triangle, which is now defined with the base length, which is a variable that we have defined in the algebra view. Now let us say I want to take an input from the students or from the user to change this triangle. The input will actually change the value of the variable that we have defined, called base length. So I'll go here and define the input box, and I will say enter base segment length. And you can make this input box linked to the object for which it needs to take the values. So you go here and you can define it to this base length variable which you have defined, right? So again, the same methods of moving the display. You move that here. So you enter it as 6. Right now it is 6, but let us say you want to change it to 8. So I want you to notice that it's actually changed. The triangle has changed. If you go to the algebra view, you will see that the base length has the value 8 now. This is how you use an input box to link the values that you take as an input to a defined variable. You can also make the input box take the values for the slider. So for the purposes of ease of demonstration, I'm going to delete this input box, create it one more time. In this case, I'm going to link it to the slider. Enter base length and link it to the slider called base. So you notice that the enter base length input box is showing a value 7, which is the same as the slider value here. So remember, we have linked this input box now to the slider and not to the base length variable that we have defined in the algebra view. So I'll go back to the input box now and say make it 9. You will notice that this triangle is changing. Notice that this triangle is not changing because this input box is not linked to this base length. Now if you want to link it to this base length, you need to create another input box and link that variable, link that value of input to the base length variable. So I hope now you've got an idea of how to use sliders and input boxes to vary parameters in a construction, and how it's also possible to build interactive lessons which students can also use for self-exploration. Hope you enjoy creating these files yourself, and goodbye until we meet you for the next video, where we will be taking up some lessons using GeoGebra.